Hello and welcome to Washington Exec's video series. So there's been a rising focus recently on formal business and digital transformation processes in ensuring enterprise IT deployment success in government in hopes of reducing the risk of federal IT investment failure. So here to talk about this and more is LMI's Director of Business Transformation, Bettina Kolleda. Thank you so much for joining me today, Bettina.
Happy to be here.
Of course. So I'd like to start by asking what you see as some of the most common pitfalls experienced by federal agencies as they roll out transformation efforts.
So there's a couple of things that we've seen. One of the main things is just not applying a holistic approach to digital and business transformation initiatives. And one of the main things that we see as a failure is when people are not put at the center of the transformations. So really not putting enough emphasis on including users at the very beginning of the planning and building process, not putting an intentional approach to change management, communications, training, and then also outreach. So it's about getting people excited about this change. And a lot of times, not a lot of emphasis has been put on that. Another pitfall is not looking at opportunities for process improvement. I think before making large IT investments, you need to take a look at, are there opportunities to improve current processes or data in order to make that implementation a success, or maybe go with a different technology depending on what is found from that research. The last thing is making large IT investments without prototyping or piloting efforts first. I think that can lead, it's certainly time consuming to a lot of expense and risk. And then at the end of a 2 or 3 year period, a lot of times our clients have put out a product or deployed a solution and found that it's a lot of time and money wasted.
I understood. So what do you believe are the keys to a successful digital or business transformation then?
Sure. So I think it's, again, going back to focusing on the people side of things. Technology transformations are not just about the technology, but about the people that are going to be adopting them, making sure those people feel engaged, identifying pockets of resistance and being very proactive about managing that prior to deployment and during deployment, and then coming up with a strategy, both about how this change is going to be rolled out, but also thinking about acquisition as well. How you're going to acquire for this new technology, especially if you're thinking about piloting or prototyping or bringing in new technology, how you're going to adjust your acquisition processes to meet those needs. Some of the longstanding acquisition practices don't really support agile development or prototyping or innovation. And so working through some of the changes in policy that support this new way of acquiring technology is really, really key. Through this, the discovery efforts for whatever implementation an organization is going through is taking a look at processes, policies, and looking for improvements first. Through the implementation and requirements collection process, also taking a look at opportunities to visualize requirements. So not just that traditional requirements collection process where, you know, there's Excel spreadsheet with thousands of rows of requirements, but actually creating mockups, visualizing user interfaces and having the users react to what that would look and feel like for them. That can save a ton of time and money.
So then how do you see the state of federal business and digital transformation evolving over the next 3 to 5 years?
Our government partners are going to try to continue to shift their acquisition practices to meet the changes in technology. I think there's also going to continue to be an emphasis on user experience. We've seen that come out in a lot of the recent executive orders. And we're also seeing a shift in a mentality where the government is going to be more of a service provider. So that change in mindset, I think, will lead to a more emphasis on that user experience and human side of things. I think the potential for increased and accelerated collaboration between government and industry. We've seen a lot of government executives and industry executives kind of flip back and forth, supporting either government or industry to learn from one another and share information. So I think there will continue to be more of that, which is really, really positive. And then, of course, continuing with the adoption of agile development practices, prototyping and proof of concept type approaches in order to really address that time to value expectation that we have from our government partners now. the past solutions, the expectation was deployment within 2 or 3 years. Now you can have a solution, at least, you know, an MVP within months, or sometimes a prototype within weeks. So I think that'll continue to occur in the next few years.
Interesting. So to close, I want to ask what you recommend agencies do moving forward to improve this outcome and how LMI is helping them get there.
It's really important to start out by developing a strategy and a solid why. I think that helps in both selecting the types of technologies that are going to support it, but also communicating a clear message. And that strategy needs to be adaptive, and it needs to be revisited pretty frequently, especially with all the changes we have going on in our environment and with technology today. And also really an emphasis on figuring out what your agile acquisition strategy is going to be and partnering with the acquisition side of the organization. But of course, planning for the people side of the implementation, planning for that early and continuing to implement that throughout your change process. We at LMI really take a holistic approach to digital transformation that includes all of those components. One of the capabilities that we've developed is called Humanly Agile, and kind of brings together human-centered design, agile software development practices, and agile acquisition practices to marry these disciplines to kind of respond to that need within our client space. This came out of some lessons learned we had with clients where there's either not enough emphasis on the user experience, or there were delays to development because there was too much time spent on design. So bringing those two practices together, building HCD into the agile ceremonies, has been something that has helped our clients be successful. It's really important to use project management best practices, change management best practices, but also a psychology science-based approach that we have that identifies different user personas, opportunities to get them onboarded more quickly, and then also pockets of resistance. So taking a very proactive approach there. And then, of course, that partnership with innovation organizations. Within LMI, we have our innovation hub called The Forge, where we develop prototypes for clients in 30 or 60 days. So leading into that prototyping process, leveraging organizations like The Forge, and then also we team with technology firms and academia, of course. I think this really all comes together to ensure that not only is the government picking the right investments to make in technology, but bringing folks along throughout the process, and therefore lowering risk and potential high expense programs.
Thank you so much. We appreciate you sharing your expertise on the evolving landscape of the formal business and digital transformation process. This clearly touches every company in GovCon, and including the government agencies themselves. So we appreciate you being here with us today.